like Downton Abbey's Mrs. Patmore or Daisy? Well, with the official Downton Abbey Cookbook, anyone can eat and drink like a Crawley. Anna Gare is here to show us just how easy it can be. G'day, how are you?
Hi, good morning.
We're obviously the downstairs mob.
You're the downstairs.
Yes, because we're working. We're cooking.
I want to be a Crawley upstairs.
I'd much rather be in the kitchen. You have so much more fun.
So what are we going to make?
Today I'm going to show you how to make a Yule log.
Look at that.
A beautiful traditional log that's made at Christmas time. I've had to cut it pretty short so I can get you girls involved.
Right,
because
good.
This would normally take about Abbey half an hour.
They would have actually eaten this.
Definitely.
Okay. What do we do?
So I've already beaten. So this is just 4 eggs and half a cup of sugar and a squeeze of lemon juice. Mm-hmm. So that's already beaten, but I need you to beat that just a little bit more till it's lovely and fluffy.
And is there, can't overbeat?
Yes, you can't overbeat, but you can. You've got to keep it nice and light because you want to aerate that mixture.
Oh, okay.
And so this is the sponge we're making.
Oh, okay, right.
Yeah, so
that's
just
what's
egg,
inside.
Sugar and lemon juice. Look how beautiful that is. Really, really simple.
Great.
We're not actually separating eggs or anything.
No.
Now all we need to do is fold in. I feel like the queen here. I've got my two assistants.
Fold in.
Then I've got 3/4 cup of flour. This is just plain flour.
You're going to sift
it. And I need you to stop whisking.
And
we're just going to sift that in. And we're fold it in.
Because
it's got to be lovely and light. If it gets lumps in there, the whole sponge consistency will just flop. Okay. So if you can just do some nice folding there with that action. Folding.
You've
nice
picked
and
out
light.
Natural
You're keeping the
cook
air
here,
in
Anna.
It. Beautiful.
That's it.
So do you do much cooking at home?
I haven't made a Yule-tide log for a while. Excuse me.
For a while.
What other recipes are in the book, Anna, while we're doing this?
Oh, there's all sorts of beautiful recipes, lots of old-fashioned recipes. And actually, in the actual Downtown Abbey DVD, that's out actually today, which I'm excited about because I've actually seen the film once, but I really want to get it home and stop and pause in all the kitchen moments and stuff. But they've got a little recipe booklet in there and it's got little cauliflower cheese.
Oh, listen
and
to this.
Cornish
pastries. Lobster cutlet.
Here we go, looking gorgeous.
Oh, no.
Eggs a la St. James. Dundee cake. That sounds a bit Australian.
Dundee, sure does.
There you go.
Sounds like
a hard yakka
deal. Okay, don't. We want to keep it nice and light. Nice and light, ladies and gentlemen. And then all we do is we pop this into a lovely flat pan. And then, of course, we just smooth it out onto the platter because we're actually going to roll this
up. How's it going to become a log?
Well, you'll see, just like that, we roll it up and I'll show you how to do that in one second.
And so you spread that all about?
We spread that all about. It's a bit like the hokey pokey now.
Okay.
And that goes out nice and evenly. And you
right
do
to the corners?
Just lightly, to the corners.
Okay.
I'm one of those people, I'm sorry, but I'm not going to let you do this. We've got to get this
You
in
wouldn't
the oven.
Be the first.
Mrs. Patmore's quite bossy in the kitchen.
Yeah. She is, yeah. I'd rather be Daisy. She nearly had an affair in
she
the yard.
She did.
The new one. Yes, anyway, so that goes into our imaginary oven, which we'll pop down here.
Lovely. Okay. And then it comes out. Would
that be an aga?
Yes, definitely an aga. When that comes... Oh, you know your ovens.
Yes, she keeps
when
her shoes
it comes
in.
Out, it comes out on the tray and it comes out flat on the tray, of course.
Wow.
But you let it cool on your tray. Slightly, but it must be warm because you want to roll it up. You want to give it a memory before you fill it with all the good stuff. So
you get a memory before you get rolled.
Yeah, you start to roll it while it's still warm.
In a tea towel.
And that way, in a tea towel, and that way it sits nicely and is ready for you when you're ready to ice it.
Beautiful.
Now, in here we have everything gorgeous. We have butter, we have icing sugar, and we have chocolate. And it looks like it's separating a little bit under the studio lights, but do you know what? It's still going to taste absolutely beautiful. And in the end, it's probably going to look more like a log.
Oh. Right.
So here is our roll. We're going to fill this now with some beautiful cherries.
I've got that.
Now, I would use fresh cherries. The book calls for, basically a cherry jam. If it falls apart, it doesn't matter.
Because you're going to glue it together.
Absolutely. So you can put cream in this as well, but we're just going to pop a little bit of jam over.
Fantastic.
And in fact, I don't even think I'll put the chocolate in the middle because we're going to have so much chocolate on the outside and I'm worried we won't have time to finish it.
So, okay.
So I but you could put chocolate in the middle.
You could put chocolate in the middle. You can put cream in the
and
middle.
Then you roll. How do I roll fresh. This?
Okay, here we go.
I've got to roll it.
Yeah, you've got to roll it.
You're going to do it, Kat?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Now, yeah, just tap that little guy in there and roll and just keep pulling the tea towel out of it.
Mm-hmm.
That's lovely. Gently. Now almost let the tea towel do the work.
Gorgeous. Oh, how good am I?
And, you know, this is the perfect dessert. This is the perfect dessert for Christmas because you can make it, especially when you have the cream filling in the middle, you can make it for 4 or 5 days
that
beforehand.
Is good stuff. Okay.
That is perfect. So now what we do is we pop that onto our ready-made platter.
That's plastic.
Yeah, plastic.
That's
ready.
Genius.
Shh. But you know,
it's not very
but
royal. Yeah.
But hey, it's when you're travelling in a suitcase, you don't want to be carrying silver trays.
The Studio 10 version of the silver. Yeah.
Gorgeous. So now what we need to do, and I feel like you need to have a little turn.
I need to have a go.
Okay. Now, so we're just going to pop this over here. We have a spatula. We give it the first coating of icing, and then we're going to pipe some to make it look like a log.
Oh, okay.
So you know the tradition of the Yule log.
Oh, like
the name came from
the divots.
Where did it come
from?
Like
European families, back in the 19th century, even earlier than that, they used to cut down a tree and for 12 days they'd chop up the tree and burn that wood because,
of really?
Course...
Oh, really? I thought it came from
Yule. Christmas was in the winter.
Oh, okay.
Would you be going faster than this?
I guess because we have central heating these days...
It's not quite.
We don't do that, so we've actually invented
this. Okay, so how do we get the stuff in here?
Assuming I've put a nice, good...
That's nice.
Do I do this?
Nice and neat because you're actually serving on this platter. Oh. Yeah, some nice big spoons in there.
Couple?
Actually, I'll show you a good trick. It's probably easier to be the one who's holding it to do it.
Okay.
So you just turn it in like that and then we spoon in that chocolate.
Oh, that is so good.
That's looking good. You can choose to do the ends or not, but I like to leave the ends open.
Yeah, you didn't do the ends on the other one.
So. I didn't. And just make sure that side bit's nice around. Yeah, just a little bit down the side.
Do they serve any tequila with this one?
No, they don't. But you know what? We have a little bit of rum in the icing and perhaps actually 4 tablespoons. Oh. And I'm thinking perhaps that's why it's separated a little bit.
That's fantastic.
I know my husband wants to separate from me when I drink too much rum. Okay, so all we're doing is we're dragging this along like this, ladies.
Oh, and that's
so much fun. I'm going to hand it over now and you just go all the way. And don't you
I am going to let everyone in our studio audience know that they're going home with a copy of the Downton Abbey movie, which is absolutely fantastic. And Anna, that is genius. What a fantastic thing to make a Yule log. Thank you so much.
Gorgeous.
Up next, do mums want to get baby advice from books or their own mums? We'll find out when Studio 10 comes right back.